As IntelliJ IDEA IE is set up, now let us try to write our first Scala program just to validate that our setup is successful. And we don't need to set up Scala separately as of now. We can write Scala-based programs directly using IDE. That being said, on the left side, you see the product name and there's a directory structure. As the font is very small, especially on the editor, let me increase the font and then I will start with the directory structure and we will take it from there. So I'm going to File, Settings, and then in the font, I'm increasing to 48. The font is on the editor. So it might look like this for you. You can expand this and choose font and you can set whatever value you want. I'm applying and then clicking on OK. Okay, now on the left side, let's get into these directories. You see dot idea and project directories. They are primarily for internal usage or internal purposes of idea to manage the project. The main directories are source and target. Source is the directory where you will be working on. Target will be automatically updated by IntelliJ IDEA whenever you change the project by compiling the changes in the project. And then we have build.sbt, and build.sbt is the one which will have these dependencies defined. The name of the application is getting started. Version of this application is 0.1, and Scala version we are going to use for our project is 2.10.7. And if you expand the source directory, there is main directory and there is test directory. So all the unit test cases should go to the test directory. All the code for your application should go to the main directory. And if you expand this, you see a directory called Scala. And these are the directories which are automatically created for you. You can right click on this Scala, go to new, and then choose Scala class, okay, to write your Scala program. Here you can give the program name. Let us name it as Hello World. And make sure to change this class to object, okay? And then click on OK. I'm not going to explain anything about these things. Just copy paste to validate that you are able to write Scala based programs using IDEA. Okay, don't worry too much about the syntax and semantics at this time. And then hit enter. And then say def main, which means we are trying to write a main function which will say hello world. So this is the syntax to write the main function. That's it. Now I can right click on this and say run hello world. Now you can see it is building the project, which means the code is being compiled and the compiled code will be saved to this target directory. You don't need to worry too much about that at this time. Once the compilation is done, then it will actually run. For the first time, it will take quite a bit of time, but once it downloads all the dependencies for the first time, from the second time, the execution will be much, much faster. Now you can see that it has printed Hello World here. In case if it say could not find or load main class, try to recompile and rerun again and it will work. And this concludes that our IntelliJ IDEA setup with Scala is successful. Now we can actually update the build.sbt with the necessary dependencies, with whatever additional plugins we want to use to develop our applications, and one of that can be Spark.